This is Guardian Radio, your station for up-to-the-minute news, intelligent, interactive, and engaging conversation. 96.9 FM. The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network.
Off the record, the Zhivargo Laing is brought to you by Burger King, the Central Bank of the Bahamas, the Cleveland Clinic, Dunkin' Donuts, Grand Bahama News, Prince Masters, RF Bank and Trust, and Royal Star Assurance.
Let me know if you're not alone. I'll love if you feel like you
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Z-Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. So glad you could join us here today on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM on this beautiful Tuesday afternoon. Tuesday, election day in the United States of America, the day when someone is going to be elected president of the United States of America. And some people are going to laugh, and some people are going to smile, and some people are going to cry, and some people are going to frown, and some people won't care. But today is that day. If at some point you want to give us a call on the show, the numbers to do so are 323-6232. That's 323-6232 or 325-4316-325. 4316 from the Family Islands. You can call us on 242-300-5720. That's 242-300-5720. You can text us on 422-4796, or you can WhatsApp me on 439-3043. We are, of course, live on Cable Bahama, channel 969, or you can catch us on PTC Flow, channel 612. So let me give you the lay of the land today. We are going to talk with some special guests first, and then after that, we're going to talk about the American election. Elections today. Again, just want to mention a couple of other things relevant to our connection to that election here in the Commonwealth of the Bahamas. But I do have with me today two very special friends. One of them has been on the show from time to time, co-hosting with me, always regularly on the show, co-hosting with Dwight Strawn on morning. So I'm talking about the one and only Laverne Gardner. Not talking about the stuff we normally talk about today. She's doing some stuff, folks. Laverne Gardner, she's here with us today with Melissa Sayers out of Grand Bahama. Good morning, ladies. These are two very dynamic ladies. Good day and hello.
Hi, Zhivargo. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm so excited to be here on Z Live.
Good afternoon, Zhivargo. I am happy to be on Z Live again.
Well, it's good to have both of you. Laverne, you got a special event coming up you want to talk to us about. So give us some details. Let us know what's going on.
Okay. If you are a woman and you are out there under the sound of my voice, mark your calendar, November 10th. That's this Sunday coming at 5 o'clock p.m. We are going from stuck to unstoppable. And so this is a workshop that I'm putting on under my brand, Hey Sis Empowerment and Resource Center for Women. So if you find yourself in a position, you know, sometimes you just feel stuck, and not necessarily in every area of your life, maybe in your career or in your finances or in a relationship. You're sitting and you're thinking to yourself, how did I get here? Or you're thinking, there's so many ideas that I talk about, that I think about, that I want to do, but I don't know how to actualize them. Or you're looking at your life and saying, I thought by now I would be a little bit further ahead. And so we are creating an environment where we can come, not just motivate you, but I've created a workbook that we will go through the workbook, and we will talk about vision and clarity, and you have activities. We will address limiting beliefs and fears. We're going to create goals and actionable steps, pair you with an accountability partner, talk about time management. And so we're going to work through this workbook. So if you find, if this is resonating with you and you are ready to do the work to go from stuck to unstoppable, then you absolutely need to be a part of this event. At the end of the event, we want each attendee to have their workbook as a blueprint to help guide them on their next steps. And, you know, we are excited about it. I have a dynamic team and Melissa is on that team, and we just know that this is going to be such a wonderful event and so meaningful in the lives of women.
Hi, Laverne. Laverne,
hello.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you. I can hear you.
Hi, Laverne.
Hi.
Okay.
Can you hear
unfortunately,
me?
I'm sorry. I didn't hear much of what you all said. I didn't hear much of what you all said because we had a technical glitch. But that doesn't mean you have to repeat all of it for me. But I missed it. I'm sorry.
Okay. Melissa, are you there? I think Melissa was speaking.
Yeah, I'm here again. Yes, I just want to say that, Zhivargo, I am so pleased to team up with Laverne and be a part of her team on this from stuck to And truth be told, this earlier, I'd first to say no to her when she had asked me because, you know, have some type of mindset when it comes to, you know, these women empowerment, motivational speaking, seminars, and not that I'm against them and not that something is wrong going to motivational seminars, but what I like about this whole setup that Laverne has designed is it's actually a workshop. The woman, we as women are responsible now to put some work in it to get from being stuck to unstoppable and understand that there is a to get from one point to the other. And so you have to try to put work in. And so I am very excited to be a part of this team. I believe that it will be very beneficial for those persons who plan to attend. And I'm looking forward to working along with Laverne and being a team member, a table team member, and to make sure that women come in and know that it is not just you who feel and stuff, that there are those at some point and even now stuck and didn't know what is the next step. How do I get from feeling this way to be able to achieve whatever it is that I put my chief and say that this is an empowerment seminar for you. You need to be in this at this place.
Hello, Zhivargo, can you
yes,
hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. I can hear
wonderful.
You. Laverne, let me ask you a question.
Sure.
What is it like? Why do you think women some women are stuck or what is it that you think causes that in the first instance? What is it that's the challenge that makes the seminar so necessary?
I think one of the challenges, and you know, there are many, but I'll speak personally for me. One of the challenges was fear, right? So there were things that I wanted to do, but there was a fear of failure because I'm going into new uncharted waters. And so I'm thinking to myself, what if I try this and it doesn't work? And so it's fear. It's telling yourself, I don't know if this,
right.
In your head, you have like this image, you want it to be perfect. And your perfectionism could cause you not to move because you keep saying to yourself, I want to make sure that I have all my ducks in a row. I want it to be, because when I come out now or whatever, when I do this thing, and that's not how life works. Sometimes you have to start with what you have in your hand and you build and you grow. But I really think that sometimes it is that lack of belief in yourself or that fear of failure. And so the biggest battle you face a lot of times is not even what they say, but it's what you are telling yourself.
Yeah.
Or sometimes
That story in your own head.
Yeah. And that can be so damaging. But you stuck right in your head, or you look at your life and you say, my time has passed. I figured, you know, we all have plans. I figured I would have this done by 30, and now I'm 50. Where I go in, it's over. No, it's not, right? It's not over. You can do this.
Yeah.
So, and you know,
one of the things that's true too is, one of the things that's true too is, which is what I love about seminars, what I love about meetings, what I love about teaching sessions, is that they help you walk through an issue in your head and give you perspectives you didn't have so that you could overcome that fear, so that you could find that courage, so that you could get that power. Sometimes that's all it takes, is being in that setting with other people.
Being in that space. Yes. And like Melissa said, and recognizing that these same kind of thoughts, negative thoughts that you have in your head, other people have had them too. And they're saying, here's how I did this. Here's how this works. So now you realize I'm not alone. Because a lot of times you were looking at people on the outside and making assumptions. Or this person has it all together. Well, of course they could do so and so. You see what school they went to? You see how many degrees they have? And not recognizing that they are facing battles themselves, but finding the tools to work through it. So all of that, you know, being in that space.
I also think, Zhivargo, that another thing is women face judgment. And you feel judged by your peers. You feel judged by those you might be in relationship with. You feel judged by your children. And you know, work, you're always feeling that you're under a microscope and you're judged. And you're thinking only you one going through this particular situation. And as Laverne stated, when you get into a room with like-minded persons, you realize that, hey, I'm not the only one that would have been facing this challenge or this issue. And you listen to hear how they work through that process. And it motivates you. Gives you encouragement that if they did it, I can do it as well. And so you don't feel as much judged, and you realize that this is life. Life can be life in sometimes, but it's just how we perceive it and what our perception is. And then we take introspection and decide that, okay, we're going to continue to move forward. We're going to get some clarity on this and move forward and make decisions that is going to move us from being stuck to unstoppable.
I can tell you one thing that I have learned over the years is that if you feel stuck, if you feel like, you know, you don't have a path, a clarity about what to do next or how to do what to do next, it helps to get in an environment where there is information, where there are people who have been where you are going or seeking to go, or people who are going where you are seeking to go, because along the path they get some information they can share with you too. So I'm 100% on putting yourself in learning motivational environments, because they make a difference. They change your life. Staying in the environment you're in is producing the results you're getting. So a new environment is how you're going to get new results. Did I just tell a lie or not?
No, that's true. That is the truth. That is the truth. And so before we wrap up, I just want to say, if you are listening and this is resonating with you, don't think that it's just for Grand Bahama. We are also offering this virtually. So if you are in New Providence or on a family island, where, or even outside of the Bahamas and you're tuned into Z Live today, you can still be a part of this workshop. We have it virtually where you will be able to experience everything that's going on in the room, ask questions, just like how they have the workbook, you will have the digital workbook as well. And so we want to capture as many women as we can. If you are interested, please hit us up at 826-6278. 826-6278. And we would love to see you virtually or in person at From Stuck to Unstoppable. Tickets are only $55. Reach out to us and let us know. I just got to shout out my sponsors. I want to say thank you to Star General, Grand Bahama Port Authority, Bahamas Institute of Business and Technology, Guardian Radio, and Imagine Graphics. This would not be coming together if they did not contribute. We are so excited. We have a team of dynamic women, ready, willing, and able, who want to pour out of themselves, and we want to connect with you.
And Laverne?
Yes.
The date of the workshop?
It's November 10th. That's this Sunday.
The date of okay, go ahead.
5 o'clock p.m. Don't wait. Melissa can tell you, like tickets, when I tell you, basically gone. Virtual aspect, the virtual is still available. So don't hesitate. Don't call someone to get someone to try to affirm you. If you know this is what you need, make sure that you take advantage of it. 826-6278, November 10th, From Stuck to Unstoppable at the Pelican Bay Resort. But as I said, we are offering it virtually as well.
We have a caller on the line, Laverne, so let's take that caller. Go ahead, caller, we're listening to you. Hi, go ahead, caller. Producer, I'm not sure we're getting that caller, so.
Yeah, I didn't know if it was dropped. Me. I'm
okay,
not
sorry about
anything.
That, Laverne. Melissa? Yeah, no, they dropped. But thank you very much. We wish you every success with the workshop, and I know people's lives are going to be changed by it. Thank you so much.
Thank you,
Shivago. Thank you, Bahamas.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to Z Live. I'm Shivago Laing, your host. We're going to take a break. We'll be back after this break.
The Whopper with cheese at Burger King Nassau has never tasted so good. It's made with 100% flame-grilled beef that's juicier, topped with fresh ingredients as usual, and even fluffier buns. Get a regular Whopper with cheese combo for only $9, including VAT, and enjoy a Whopper that's bigger, better, and tastier. The only place to get your Whopper with cheese combo is at Burger King Nassau, where it's grill time anytime.
All those loans I had were so overwhelming. Fidelity's debt consolidation loan combines all my loan payments into one easy payment with a built-in savings plan that pays me unbeatable interest. It's time to make that move to Fidelity. Call 356-7764.
Fidelity, we're good for you.
Marcia, the lady run into me, Marcia.
I hope she had insurance.
If she had insurance, she hop out, pull out her phone, pull up the Royal Star Assurance app, and bang, she was on a video call with an RSA rep, sending pictures of her damage, my damage, filing a claim on the spot.
For real? Our insurance have that kind of app?
You gotta go to RSA for that.
Download the RSA app today or visit rsabahamas.com to submit your claim online. Live chat available weekdays 9 to 5.
The Grand Bahama News is available every Tuesday in the Nassau Guardian. You can buy your local paper at Freeport convenience stores, Western Bakery, De Gregory's Fine Foods, and Bellevue Gifts. Now is the time to reach your Grand Bahama market with affordable packages, including print and digital. Call GB News Sales Representative Kavandre at 822-6717 or message him on WhatsApp per ad rate. Classified ads are now available every Tuesday as well. Keep up with everything Grand Bahamian every Tuesday in the Nassau Guardian.
Girl, you see how Cora eye look funny all black up yesterday?
But she says she bumped into a wall when she's running after the turn them.
Yeah, but last Saturday you see her arm was all black and blue, right?
What you saying? You think something wrong between her and Jack?
I ain't sure, but you know Jack is a jealous man. I hear him and Cora last Friday. I hear him say he hear Cora have eyes for Junior.
Now you know that ain't true. Cora is a good woman. Does mind her business, take care of them turn and go to church every Sunday. So what you think we should do?
I think we should report Jack, you know. Cora don't say nothing, but silence hides violence. And we don't want to line up in the cemetery.
Not me. I ain't getting in nobody business. Then Jack come after me and I line up next to Cora.
No, man, we could call or text Crime Stopper. And remember, we can even get some grocery money for our tip.
Remind me again how this work.
We can call him in Miami at 328-TIPS or 328-8477. Or when we in the island, call toll free at 300-TIPS or 300-8477. And if you don't have no minutes, use the Crack Crime Bahamas app and we could text them and the messages get on mix up before it leave your phone. So nobody can know what you're saying.
So what are we waiting on then? Let's go earn some grocery money.
This is Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
I'm not afraid to take a stand.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. So glad you could join us here today on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM on this beautiful Tuesday afternoon, Election Day in the United States of America. If you want to give us a call on the show, the numbers are 323-6232 or 325-4316. You can text us on 4224796 or WhatsApp me on 439-3043. We are, of course, live on Cable Bahamas Channel 969 or BTC Flow Channel. You can call us from the Family Islands on 242-300-5720. At some point, over the next month or so, within the next month or so, I'm putting it like that because you can leave room for all kinds of things. We will know who the president of the United States of America will be, the new president of the United States of America will be, as they are now continuing and finalizing votes for that position, as well as a number of down ballot positions. Today, in the United States, this morning, and said, why are y'all focusing on the United States of America's elections? We have our own problems. And of course, I'm not surprised to hear that kind of comment because there are some people who simply do not make the connection. They just don't know. They don't really understand how integrated the world is. They don't understand how integrated the Commonwealth of the Bahamas is. They don't know and understand that that policies, events in other parts of the world, particularly for the Bahamas, in the United States of America, can drastically affect our affairs. They don't know. I mean, literally do not understand that. And that if you are a leader of the Commonwealth of the Bahamas, you have an interest in what happens in the United States of America. There's no question you do. you want to understand, okay, if this is going to be the next president of the United States of America, espousing these kinds of policies, et cetera, then it is possible that that could shape our lives in this way. We get the bulk of our tourists from the United States of America. We get the bulk of our trade, do the bulk of our trade with the United States of America. We get our corresponding banking through the United States of America that is so important for financing the affairs of the Commonwealth of the Bahamas. Many of our citizens go over to the United States of America for schooling, for medical attention, for recreation. A number of our citizens live in the United States of America. And the list of implications of things in America go on and on and on. We sit between the United States of America and Latin America, therefore making us one of the major transshipment points for drugs and other things. So to suggest that we should pay attention to the United States of America could only tell me that such a person just really, honestly doesn't understand. And that's possible. You know, that you know, maybe you never looked at it. Maybe you never studied it. Maybe no one ever taught it to you. Never gave you any information about it. But it matters. It matters whether Donald Trump or Kamala Harris is president of the United States of America. Their perspectives, whether their policies translate into economic gains that then translate into fortunes for Americans that could lead to them wanting to travel and among their travel choosing the Bahamas, that's possible. Whether they have policies that tighten up their banking systems in terms of foreign relationships, et cetera, matters to whether or not our correspondent banking scenario continues. Who they choose to lead the Federal Reserve and how they approach the management of the U.S. Monetary policy all could affect the way things are in the Commonwealth of the Bahamas. So it matters. It matters all day. Now, as I listened to Morning Blend and heard Pamela Ferguson and I forgot the name of the other guest. It's a gentleman who he's a Bahamian, but labeled himself a Republican and a Trumpster. No, he didn't label himself a Trumpster, but somebody who clearly is sympathetic to Donald Trump. I listened to some of his commentary, and I was especially alarmed about his commentary about the Bahamas. He said that the Bahamas does not have a youth bloc. Does not have a youth bloc? Really? He talked about Bahamian children still voting the way their mother wants them to vote. For some people, yeah, but that's a bit of not knowing how Bahamians vote. He must have missed that in the years for sure. Okay, producer, we back. Are we back, producer? Let me know. Are we back? Am I back? Did I drop?
Life back. purchase or occasion? Do you want your money to start making money for you? Well, let me introduce myself. My name is Bond, the Bahamas Government Savings Bond. I am guaranteed to earn interest on your money with terms ranging from 1 to 6 years. Government savings bonds are available to all Bahamians, and for as little as $100, you can start to save for your future. The Bahamas Government Savings Bond, a safe investment guaranteed. Check out the Central Bank of the Bahamas website for details.
For fast, reliable, and impactful printing services, look no further. Let Printmasters bring your masterpiece to life. We stand by our quality products that is second to none. Our affordable pricing and friendly, efficient staff makes Printmasters the ultimate choice for all your printing needs. We can deliver any type of printing services, from banners to booklets to business cards. You name it, we can print it.
Let Printmasters bring your masterpiece to life.
Located in the Nassau Guardian Building, telephone 302-2361.
Are you a business owner or HR professional? RF's team of pension specialists are here to empower your employees with market-leading retirement solutions and to make implementing group pensions easy and cost-effective. With RF, starting or switching your company pension plan is a breeze, and there are no setup fees. If you're looking for strong investment performance and low fees, visit rfgroup.com/empower and empower your team to retire comfortably with RF Group Pensions today. That's rfgroup.com/empower.
Love the show? Want to give your support? Become a sponsor today. Call 302-2300 for our rates and packages. That's 302-2300. Become a sponsor on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
Always on the go? Miss the show? You can now listen to Guardian Radio talk shows anytime, anywhere on Spotify and YouTube by searching Guardian Radio 96.9 FM or by entering the name of your favorite show. You can also listen by logging on to guardiantalkradio.com and clicking on the podcast tab. Guardian Radio, continuing to provide you with fresh news and smart talk anywhere, anytime, all day.
This is Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. So glad you could join us here today on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. On this beautiful Tuesday afternoon, we'll be talking about the fact that perhaps one of the biggest events taking place in the world today is happening right in the United States of America, where they are voting to elect the new president of the United States of America. Either that will be Kamala Harris or the present vice president, or it will be Donald Trump, the former president of the United States of America. I was saying that one of the things that people sometimes miss in the course of talking about Donald Trump's popularity despite his personality is that if you look at the majority of Americans, they don't vote for Donald Trump. Hillary Clinton had millions of people more voted for her to be president than did vote for Donald Trump. Donald Trump had more people vote for him last time to be president, last time than he had the first time to be president, but he still lost to Biden by more votes than he got. And so across America, Donald Trump is not the most popularly voted for person, but he did win the Electoral College when he won in 2016, and he could win the Electoral College again this time, even if he doesn't get the popular vote. So when people talk about Americans choosing Donald Trump, that's not true. Not if you're talking about Americans as who gets the most American votes, because he does not. Right? Also, lots of Americans don't vote in their elections. In fact, 50% of plus percent of Americans don't. The Americans don't have 50 plus percent of Americans who are eligible to vote. So it is no president of the United States of America in modern history has ever been elected by a majority of eligible American voters. There's always been, therefore, a minority of people who have voted for their presidents. So to some degree, only a quarter of the eligible voters of America have voted for their presidents, right? And so that's a really small minority that have voted for them. So when people asked, one of the questions that was posed on the show this morning was whether or not people in America are ready to elect a woman president. Well, they demonstrated that the last time Hillary Clinton ran. As I said, more of them voted for Hillary Clinton than voted for Donald Trump. So the question as to whether they are ready for that, the answer is yes, because they showed that in the popular vote. Just that this construction they have, this compromise system of electoral college, didn't produce a result for Hillary Clinton, right? But in terms of what the majority of Americans, and they wanted that white woman, who is a woman of color, get the majority of votes in America? Yes. Does she have to win the presidency? No. Depends on whether she wins the sufficient electoral college votes. We have a call on the line. Go ahead, caller. We're listening to you.
Hello?
Go ahead, caller. We're listening to you.
All right, sir, but you can hear me?
Yes, we're listening to you, sir.
Good day, Mr. Laing. Can you hear me?
Very well.
Okay, Poppy. Let me start off.
I can hear you very well.
Okay, let me ask this question. You already touched the I don't think it's minimum wage, but what they say about the middle class and Freeport and Nassau, because I know you're the expert in this. You already say something about it? You already talk about it? Minister?
Only to say that there's a delay, so you have to listen for me. There's a delay in the programming, so just listen up and give it some time, and you'll hear me.
Yeah,
but
I
indicated, Papa, that on next... Next week, Wednesday, we'll be dealing with that. We'll have the actual lead researcher on ZLive, and we'll be talking about it next week, Wednesday.
Yes, sir. Okay, that'll be great. Next thing, I want to know, although I can't see, sometimes I'd be right with my feeling things, but, ain't nothing like seeing it, and then you still don't know until it happened. But I don't want to know from you. When we had the last election in 2021, September 16th, could you feel that it was could be a change? Could you, see that with your eyes, or could you really feel the I don't want to say the excitement, because to some of us it was excitement, but could you feel like the government was getting a change and there's a possibility that us, the Bahamian people, was going to give Brave Davis a chance? I mean, when I say Brave Davis, the New Day government, why I say that, right? I want to know now, although you don't live in the United States, can you feel, what are you feeling or what are you seeing? You see the people want to continue with the same, or you see them going back, bringing Donald Trump with the ideas, what he say? How you feel about it? How you feel about it? Because when I listen, it sound like they are going to give Donald Trump not a run for his money, but give him the victory. And I listen to Donald Trump. When I hear him, that's the same old Donald Trump. Say what he meaning, and at least say things to them, even if it come across a little rough. This lady, I can't issue loss. Help me out. Help us out. Who ain't see it, or who ain't feeling it, or who ain't feeling it? What is her policy? What is her plan? Because some of the things what they was bringing us up to date with what she was for, it's like she either changed everything, or she just saying what she think the American people want to hear right now. What are you feeling? Are you seeing a change? I'll hang up and give you a chance to answer. Thanks.
Okay, thanks. Thanks for calling, Pop. Appreciate it. As for our last election and how I felt, I didn't feel any way about the election. I didn't feel any excitement. I didn't feel any optimism about whether one side was going to win or the other. But I did reason. I reasoned. In my head, I reasoned that the Free National Movement was going to lose. I reasoned that because of the sentiments I had heard from people about Dr. Minnis, about his behavior, about his treatment of people, and all the other factors that I think lent to people saying, you know what, enough of this. I had no idea so many people were going to stay away from the polls as did. I had no idea. I didn't dream that that was possible. But I did believe that the FNM was going to lose the last election for sure. In terms of how I feel about the American election, I have the same feeling. I have no feelings about it one way or the other. I can't say that I have any good feeling that Kamala Harris is going to win, any good feeling that Donald Trump is going to win. I have no feelings about it one way or the other. Even my reasoning doesn't do a lot of justice to me in terms of the outcome. Outside of this, people who have been very accurate on predicting elections in the United States of America, such as the professor about whom I spoke the other day, they seem to believe and predict that Kamala Harris is going to win. That's what they seem to be predicting. Donald Trump's behavior to me says he is a losing candidate. When you start appealing to people cheating, when you start appealing to, they're doing a lot of crooked things, when you start appealing to the only way we'll lose it, you're telling me, you're sending signals to me that your own internal information isn't making you comfortable and confident that you're going to win. So based on those things, I give Kamala Harris an edge. But again, I don't have a feeling one way or the other. I don't know what's going to happen. Kamala Harris's policy positions to me are much clearer than what I've heard from Donald Trump. Asked about what she wants to do, economically speaking, she wants to give $50,000 in credit to people seeking to start a new business. She wants to provide that kind of business subventions to these people. She wants in the healthcare arena to provide subventions to people to enable them to take care of their elderly parents who want to stay home as opposed to go in a home. She speaks about those kinds of things on the situation in Iraq. In Israel. She's indicated Israel has a right to defend itself and they would support Israel defending themselves, but that the Palestinians have a right to their own determination, et cetera, et cetera. So whether you agree with her positions or not, and those are just a few of the positions she's articulated, whether you agree with them or not, she's articulated something. All of them are immigrants in America, and he's going to take them out of the United States of America and send them back home. Practically speaking, I don't see how it happens, but that's what his intention is. I could only see that being a cruel exercise in humanity. Even in terms of it's working logistics, but that's what he wants to do. He wants to get rid of Obamacare. He has a concept of a plan to get rid of Obamacare. So he's mentioned those kinds of things. What's his policy in the world? When Donald Trump gets elected, the world, he'll be stronger and the world will fear him. That's what I've heard. I haven't heard anything else articulated from him. So I think when it comes to policy positions, if people are being fair and objective and not being emotional, Kamala Harris has the most clearly articulated policy positions of both. When it comes to the way they handle themselves in the public and deal with people, Kamala Harris has done a much better job than Donald Trump in that regard. When it comes to the kind of personality and attitudes that would make me fair for the democracy of the United States of America and its stability, Kamala Harris has demonstrated greater stability and competence in that regard than, say, Donald Trump, hands down. So, but how I feel about the outcome of this election, I don't have no feelings about it one way or the other. I have hopes, but I don't have no feelings. I hope that answers your question, Papa. Another thing that I wanted to speak to in terms of some of the things that I hear people saying about voting and the election. Like, so I heard Dwight continuously ask his guest, the gentleman who's there, what do you think? What do you think? And he kept going back to, well, you have to talk to the people who are local and the views they have and the sentiments they have. Yeah, that's true if you want to get their views. But I'm asking you what your view is. That's what I'm asking you, not them. I'm asking you their views. And when sometimes these folks start venturing into the moral space, I really think that if you are trying to help Donald Trump, you should stay out of the moral space. Really. I mean, like, just stay out of it. Don't say, listen, man, this ain't about morality. This is about strength. This is about perceived strength. This is about perceived boldness. Because maybe you can get a win with Donald Trump around that. But don't talk about morality. Don't talk about character. Like, stay out of that arena if you're trying to do Donald Trump a favor. Right? I don't see how Donald Trump gets to win on the moral front. I don't see how he gets to win on the character front. If you want to talk money and having money and believe in having money makes you a great president, okay, you could talk about Donald Trump. But don't talk about character. Don't talk about clarity of vision. Don't talk about clarity of positions. Don't talk about articulation of positions. Don't talk about intelligence, that kind of stuff, because you can't listen to a woman like Kamala Harris and then think anything other than she is stronger than Donald Trump in all those areas. You have to be, to my mind, you have to be deluded, disinterested, or dishonest to try and give her a worse score than a Donald Trump. And that gentleman told me everything about himself. I'll be honest with you. I listened by doing this, mispronouncing Kamala's name. He wasn't making any mistakes. He was being Trumpian in doing that, in my view. And I thought it was a great disservice to himself, because an intelligent person who knows how to sound out words would not struggle with the pronunciation of Kamala's name. Not an intelligent person. Let me say that again. If you are an intelligent person who's done any basic level of English language where you know how to break down words into syllables, if you know how to do that, are struggling with Kamala's name means that you did nothing in English language, or you are just being dishonest about the pronunciation of her name. And to do that, to me, is a disservice to your own intelligence. And it struck me as I listened to him as something entirely defenseless. A black person should not do that to a black person or any person. Ladies and gentlemen, listening to Z Live, we're going to take a break for news. We'll be back after the news break.
And I just can't keep living this way. So starting today, I'm breaking out of this cage.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.
This is the afternoon update on the Guardian News Network. Hello, everyone. I'm Bonnie Toot. Topping news, it is election day in the United States. Millions of Americans are heading to the polls to vote for their next president. Vice President Kamala Harris and former President Donald Trump each need at least 270 electoral votes to win. The battleground states of Arizona, Georgia, Michigan, Nevada, North Carolina, Pennsylvania, and Wisconsin are expected to be pivotal in the hotly contested race. Here in the Bahamas, the Unregulated Communities Action Task Force began demolishing over 100 illegal structures in the Tiwash community in southern New Providence today. It comes weeks after eviction notices were served to residents. Superintendent Stephen Carey says this will be the last community the task force carries out demolitions in this year, but the group will resume the removal of shantytowns next year. A 19-year-old man is in hospital after being shot last night. Police say around 7:20 p.m., ShotSpotter technology detected gunshots in the area of Hercules Way and Saxon Way in Mason's Addition. According to initial reports, the victim was riding a bicycle east on Hercules Street when two men approached him. One of the men pulled out a firearm and shot the victim before fleeing the scene. He sustained multiple gunshot wounds and was taken to hospital where he is listed in serious condition. And that's a look at news. Stay with us. AP Update is coming up.
This November, the Nassau Guardian is celebrating 180 years. And we want to thank you, our loyal readers, for helping to make this one of the oldest newspapers in the region. We want you to be a part of our Vision Challenge giveaway promotion beginning October 28th through November 22nd. All you need to do is find the hidden Nassau Guardian 180 years logo printed every day in the Nassau Guardian newspaper, and you could win prize money. Just purchase your daily Nassau Guardian newspaper every day beginning Monday, October 28th. Find the 180th Nassau Guardian logo, cut out the page, mark the spot, write your name and phone number on that clipping, drop off your entries at our offices on Carter Street in Oaksfield. And every Friday, November 1st, November 8th, November 15th, and November 22nd, one drawing will take place. It's that simple.
Wait, you know what's going down tomorrow?
Nobody, what happening?
Joe bringing me knives to school? He could do it on you in?
For what?
Wait, he fooled with Joe girl?
Mother sick. And you know, Joe, you don't bog down for nothing. So that means you got a big fight tomorrow.
So whose side you want?
Side? I trying to stay in school, not Simpson fan. You got to tell somebody about this fight.
Tell somebody? I ain't no snitch. I mean, cool, you know.
Wait, if you so cool, then you need to stay in school and stay out of the fight.
Yeah, but if I don't hang on Joe's side, him and he boys coming for me next.
All right, so we definitely got to tell somebody. We got to prevent the fight.
What I say? I don't want nobody call me snitch.
You could just call Crime Stoppers. You could report what you know, and nobody got to know it's you.
So how do I work?
All you got to do is call them, or you text them through the Crack Crime Bahamas app, and nobody can know it's you.
Then the police come looking for me for more info, and when they finish with them, Joe them coming looking for me? Uh-uh.
When you call Crime Stoppers, the calls go directly to Miami, and they don't ask nothing about you. Then if you get the pen from them, and they can claim a reward later using that same pen.
Plus, everything's scrambled, so nobody can read what you said.
Calls 308-8477 from Nassau, or 242-300-8477 from the Family Islands.
It turns out that there is more than one special gift to give that special someone this Christmas. Consumers are searching for the perfect presents and the right prices. So why not place your products or services in the Nassau Guardian's Holiday Gift Guide? And this year's Christmas shoppers will be sure to find that special something for everyone on their list. For an all-inclusive price, you can have your ads published twice in December in the Nassau Guardian's Holiday Gift Guide, in addition to 10, 15, and 30-second commercials, and not to mention a web ad on the Nassau Guardian's website. Advertising deadline, remember, is November 29th. For more information, contact your sales agents or call the Nassau Guardian Advertising Department at 302-2300. That's 302-2300. And ask about our Holiday Gift Guide Media Bundle. You don't want to miss this opportunity. Ring in those holiday profits by placing an ad in the Nassau Guardian Holiday Gift Guide.
This is Guardian Radio, your station for up-to-the-minute news, intelligent, interactive, and engaging conversation. 96.9 FM.
Come take my hand, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm.
Welcome back. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. We're so glad you could join us here today on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM on this beautiful Tuesday afternoon. Call us at 323-36232. That's 325-4316 from the Family Islands. You can call us on 242-300-5720. That's 242-300-5720. You can text us on 422-4796. That's 422-4796. So you can WhatsApp me on 439-3043. We're talking U.S. presidential elections today taking place. They are voting. Lots of, I think almost 100 million people voted prior to now, and lots more to go. They'll probably get upwards to 70% of all of the eligible voters who registered to vote voting for today. The last time they had anywhere close to that, in it was 80-some percent. It was like this was over 100 years ago, I think. So, but everybody is predicting a close vote. So let me tell you what I believe. This is what I believe will happen. It's not a prediction. This is what I believe will happen. I don't think that the Electoral College is going to be close. By that I mean, I don't think there's going to be like two or three or four votes separating the winners in the Electoral College. I actually believe one of those persons is going to win the Electoral College by 300 or more votes, I think. That's what I believe. It'll either be Kamala Harris or be Donald Trump. I think the popular vote will go to Kamala Harris. I do think so. I think women voters in particular will drive that, and I think young educated voters will drive when they look at these elections, I think that they will see that many polls underrepresented sentiments of people who did not want to disclose how they would vote one way or the other. But I think that there is a latent set of voters lingering out there in support of one or two of those candidates. Now, my view is that that latent support will break for Kamala Harris. That's my view. It'll break for Kamala Harris. If it breaks for Donald Trump, it'll be a significant break for him. All right? I do not believe, I could be dead wrong, but I don't believe that there's going to be any 2 and 3 and 4 days of waiting to see who won. I believe there'll be 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 days or weeks of complaining that the election was stolen, because American elections under Donald Trump have become more like Bahamian Junkanoo results. They cheat us. They cheat us. I expect that that will continue. I expect that Donald Trump is going to probably call a victory early to create some confusion when the results start to turn on him, because early results are likely to go for the Republicans as they typically do. And then later on, as the votes come in from the larger cities and so forth, it'll turn to the Democrats. And then as the mail-in results come in, they will also tend to generally turn to the Democrats. And then he'll say, see, they're cheating because I was leading and so forth and so forth. I expect that to happen. And I expect some crying to happen in America and in the Bahamas. Love Daily. Daily. Who I expect to be crying to. If I lose in terms of what I expect to happen and would like to happen, I'm going to cry. I'm going to feel very badly. I was in the United States of America when, in 2016, when Donald Trump beat Hillary Clinton. By about 10:30, they hadn't called the elections yet, but it was clear to me where it was headed. And I went to bed, and I went to bed like somebody who had the flu. So listen, if America has a, like, if John McCain had beaten Barack Obama, I would have been disappointed, but I would not have been concerned. John McCain, a decent guy, was a decent guy. And I expected him to be a good president of the United States of America. If what's his name? Mitt Romney had beaten Barack Obama, I would have been disappointed, but I would not have been concerned. I would have expected Mitt Romney to be a good president of the United States of America. I could think of a number of Republicans who, if they won the election, the presidential election, I would have no concern about America. I think America would be in great hands. Similarly for Democrats. So be careful thinking that some of the people who have concerns about the elections now have concerns about Republicans versus Democrats. That's nonsense. There's no question that Bahamians tend to have more conservative moral leanings than they have liberal moral leanings. And I happen to be one of them, even though I understand state politics, I think, with some better nuance than some religious people who I think talk nonsense when they are talking about moral issues in the context of politics. Literally talking nonsense. They don't know, don't understand, or just don't want to. But we tend to lean conservative in many respects on moral issues, etc. Right? So this isn't about Republican versus Democrat. This is about the person. And some people say, oh, a personality don't matter, policy don't matter. Y'all stop talking nonsense, man. Personalities bleed in policy. Stop talking nonsense. Personalities bleed in policies. Spoken, written, and unwritten, formal and informal. People's personalities bleed into their politics and into their policies. You have to be someone who is not paying attention to think otherwise. So what a person believes, how a person approaches life, how they deal with people, their attitudes, whether a person is cynical or optimistic, whether a person believes that the world is a dark and dangerous place or a wonderful, optimistic place, whether a person can relate and interact with people good or not, these matter to how they play their public policies out. They don't have to only matter, but they can matter. And so to suggest to me that if a person has a twisted personality, has a schizophrenic personality, has a dark and malicious personality, and that won't matter to their leadership in the world, is to tell me you understand nothing about human affairs. Nothing. The Bible says, when the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice. But when the wicked bear rule, the people mourn. What would you think righteousness and righteousness in policy? Righteousness is personality, beliefs. Huh? You have to be, what are you thinking? What a person believes in their heart, what a person's character is, bleeds into their behaviors, leadership. Because there are parts of leadership that don't have nothing to do with a specific, clear, and defined and written law. It's about how you use power. How you come to the view that power should be used at a certain time, and upon whom that power should be used. Whether you treat your opponents as enemies, and therefore take the power and turn it on them. That matters to your personality. So don't give me this personality don't matter. What kind of world you live in? Personality matters a lot. And that's why people vote personality, not just in the Bahamas. They do it in the United States of America, too. I hear the Republicans. I heard Donald Trump. I heard Dr. Phil. Dr. Phil now. Who is it? A celebrity. He gets up on Donald Trump's stage in a rally and talks about who needs celebrity endorsement. Apparently Donald Trump does, because that's why he has you there. Because before you were known as Dr. Phil, who the heck was going to invite you to? And I wonder sometimes these people be listening to themselves when they speak. Why would Donald Trump invite Hulk Hogan to his rallies? Because he's a celebrity. You know how many other wrestlers exist in America whose names are not known? How many of them was invited to Donald Trump's rally? Not a single one. Why does Donald Trump hang around Kanye West? Because he was not a celebrity. It was more than that, because he was a black celebrity. Personality matters. And personalities matter. And celebrities matter. See, oh, I don't know if these celebrity votes can make a difference. You think they can make a non-difference? You think they can make an undifference? You think Taylor Swift can't bring 100 people to vote? Really? Beyonce can't get 100 bees to vote? you think all of these Puerto Rican celebrities like J-Lo and them can't persuade nobody to vote? Nobody. Anyway, you always know when your opponents, anytime you're in politics and your opponents criticize the thing you do, keep doing that thing. You hear me? Listen to me. Then your opponents don't say nothing. You should think about whether you should keep doing it. But if you do something and your opponents tell you you shouldn't do it, you should keep doing that thing. Your opponent said, oh, look at that, got celebrities here and celebrities here. We don't need them celebrities. And they, why do you keep bringing the celebrities? Because they don't need. We have some callers on the line. Go ahead, callers. We're listening to you. Caller, we're listening to you.
Good afternoon, Zhivargo.
Go ahead, caller. We're listening to you.
Good afternoon, Zhivargo.
Yeah.
Hey,
how you doing?
This is amazing that Obama, well, the president, he came downstairs in a tan suit. In the press, do you know the Republicans carry on? That was undemocratic to wear a tan suit in the Oval Office. With a Trump come downstairs in a bathrobe, that's okay. I mean, like, he's lowered the standard so bad as being president. Like, it's like we are saying in the Bahamas, we don't hit women. Last night, he's like, Tanzania punched her in her face. And they laugh. So, I mean, the morning goes, who raised these people? Who are Donald Trump rally? The next woman, he's like, chained and be shot in her face. I mean, like, these things are just. That's probably, I guess, how he was raised now. His granddaddy was an immigrant German. His mother was an immigrant Scottish who used to clean houses. But he using the race card that he got clean up the American bloodline. The American bloodline has been poisoned by Negroes and Latinos. So he has the rednecks hoping that this could come back again. They could be back in power again. And he raising the fears of the people who subtle racists, and they're saying some, like, what do you even call her? You call her dumb, stupid, can't talk. Like, it's like every black person is supposed to can't talk, we can't think, we have low IQ. This woman is a lawyer, a AG of a state, a senator, but you still have no respect for her. I mean, they would pay to see us do sports, jump, and run. They have millions, but to give us power? Nope. Black people ain't deserve power. Most of the white people that I know, we ain't deserve power. We could run and jump and sing and dance, but to give us power, they would die first. And like, Obama came, served 2 years, left. Trump served 1 term and carry on more secret files, and he don't believe in law or rule. I mean, he have more lawyers now, need lawyers. He had more lawyers going to jail, more people going to jail because he don't believe in law and order. He wanted, like, how he run his business. Nobody tell him no. Nobody tells him no. General Kelly say,
I got you, friend. Thank you very much. I appreciate you calling. Thanks a lot. Appreciate it. We have another caller on the line. Go ahead, caller. We're listening to you.
Yeah, man. I got you. I really wish Hamans would tune into you because you say things, if you listen to it carefully, it's very profound. Personality bleeds into policies. There seems to be so much truth in that, Zhivargo. You can't come to make a policy wherever you want to do it without applying your personality. Now, I hope we're electing people as we go forward who have the charisma to charm, but also have the truth behind them and the honesty backing them, because, you know, we got these charmers, you know. But what I'm more concerned about is this. What's going on now is there seems to be a movement away from the SWIFT transaction process, where for me to give you 10,000 of my African dollars, I have to exchange it to U.S. dollars to go into your Canadian dollar. There seems to be a move to cut out the U.S. dollar SWIFT transaction, similarly to what's happening with Bitcoin and Ethereum and all those other cryptocurrencies. I want to know from you, how do you see that affecting the trade? Because you mentioned trade as being the bottom line. The trade and trickling down to how much money is going to now be in my bank account when the U.S. dollar is being moved away from the conversion experienced by the African countries, particularly now where if I'm an African, I want to sell you gold. I don't now have to convert. You don't have to convert your money to U.S. dollars anymore. Just convert it to my African dollar. Because the strange thing is, 1,000 of my African dollars worth one of your U.S. dollars, but I got all the gold. Something wrong with that, right? Gotta be, eh?
No, ain't nothing wrong with that at all.
Okay, but how do you see that?
No, nothing's wrong with that at all.
Let me answer the question.
So
you're cutting in.
But it don't work like that though. So can I answer your question?
You're cutting in and out, but I can hold still. This phone.
Can I answer your question? Okay. When we come back from the break. No. When we come back from the break, you listen and I'll answer your question, okay?
I appreciate you, Zhivargo.
You're listening to Z Live on Zhivargo, like your host. We'll be back after this break. Appreciate you too, bro.
Owner or HR professional? RF's team of pension specialists are here to empower your employees with market-leading retirement solutions and to make implementing group pensions easy and cost-effective. With RF, starting or switching your company pension plan is a breeze, and there are no setup fees. If you're looking for strong investment performance and low fees, visit rfgroup.com/empower and empower your team to retire comfortably with RF Group Pensions today. That's rfgroup.com/empower.
Always on the go? Miss the show? You can now listen to Guardian Radio talk shows anytime, anywhere on Spotify and YouTube by searching Guardian Radio 96.9 FM or by entering the name of your favorite show. You can also listen by logging on to guardiantalkradio.com and clicking on the podcast tab. Guardian Radio, continuing to provide you with fresh news and smart talk anywhere, anytime, all day.
I marched the car. The lady run into me marched the car.
I hope she had insurance.
If she had insurance, she hop out, pull out her phone, pull out the Royal Star Assurance app, and bang, she was on a video call with an RSA rep, sending pictures of her damage, my damage, filing a claim on the spot.
For real? Our insurance have that kind of app?
You gotta go to RSA for that.
Download the RSA app today, or visit rsabahamas.com to submit your claim online. Live chat available weekdays 9 to 5.
Love the show? Want to give your support? Become a sponsor today. Call 302-2300 for our rates and packages. That's 302-2300. Become a sponsor on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
This is Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk,
quality.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. I'm so glad that you could join us here today on Guardian Radio 2, where we are the U.S. Presidential elections taking place here in the United States of America. I told you guys before that, regrettably, my PSA since my surgery has been going up, and so now I'm having to do some radiation, and I'm going to be in the U.S. for a little bit doing that. And so I'm here. I'm going to be here during during the election, and be here for the results, and be here for what happens after the results. Let's hope that what happens after the results is civil, orderly, because any disruption to even the American system, even for their own politics, can bleed into our circumstances in the Commonwealth of the Bahamas. And we are not wanting that, because we have enough struggles as it is trying to ensure that we can prosper as a nation and remain stable as a nation. And so that's the bottom line. But I was going to say to the gentleman who called, who I appreciate as well, having all the gold in the world, either in ores somewhere in your mountains or in your caves, doesn't make your dollar rich at all. Has nothing to do with your currencies. Value, because we don't have gold-backed currencies anymore. Really, what matters is the extent to which you have products and services that other people want. And services is the extent to which they need your currency to pay for those services and products. And therefore, the demand for your currency is what drives the value of your currency, the same as the demand for your labor drives the value of your labor. So it's not a question of how much, who has the gold. Secondly, the American currency being accessible to you is something that, as long as you continue to trade with America, is what you want. And I see nothing taking place that's going to cause you to not have access to American currency. Americans want that because Americans want you to trade with them. The fact that there may be alternatives to having to get things without going through the American currency is actually good for you. It's better for you because your dependency on these corresponding banking arrangements with the American banks is also a limitation to you if they decide to be at odds with you about your circumstances. That's one of the things that we saw during international regulatory changes that have threatened our correspondent banking. So that's actually not something that would be a hindrance to African countries or yourself. It would be a help if they didn't have to go through the U.S., through the SWIFT system, and so forth. But as long as there's still access to it, then there should be no difficulty. We have a call on the line. Go ahead, caller. We're listening to you.
Mr. Lang, I've got to ask you the question about tariffs. Like Trump brag about Mexico can pay for the wall, the tariffs, China can pay for the wall.
Yeah.
But the tariffs would mean that the American people will have to pay more taxes, right?
Who paid the tariffs, that he will put on the imports from China? The American people? And by them, us.
The tariffs are paid by the American people.
But Trump didn't explain it to the people. He made that he can punish China.
Well, let's be complete in our discussions about it now. Let's be complete. So the tariff is levied on the item you are importing.
Yes.
The importer will pay the tariff. That means that the American will pay the tariff. However, the tariff makes the exporter, China, for instance, product more expensive. Well, if your product is more expensive, then somebody would demand less of it. If there is a complementary product, for instance, one produced in America, then it is possible that they will want the product produced in America because it's more affordable. Now, however, if the American was producing the product in China because it was more cost effective, then you have just driven the American producer to have a more expensive product, which again still adds to the expense of the American people, even if it might create some additional production for America. In the totality of the scenario, depending on how it plays out, everybody could lose. That's why tariff wars are not good for trade in the world, and it's not good for trade in countries. Because
then he say, if this new Mexican president do what he say, he'll ask tariffs on Mexican imports. He don't know. Most of the cars are made in Mexico. I come by train back to the States. NAFTA wouldn't kick in, Danny.
Yeah.
Because remember that, he's so headstrong, he believe he know it all.
There is no NAFTA.
There is no NAFTA. And these things he make up in his mind. That tariffs, he could punish China through tariffs. He's going to make the prices go up for the Americans.
Sorry, NAFTA.
What's coming from wherever? I don't know, bro. I just hope that he reaches the last of Donald Trump and he goes to his court hearings and do what he got to do. But I don't know. It's just a terrible thing for the country to go through from January the 6th last year. Do you think he's going to accept this peacefully? Because he has too much to lose. Anyhow, thanks.
NAFTA is the law of the United States of America. Sorry, not the FTAA is not. Effect, but he would have to create a violation in the NAFTA agreement, then it's a matter that the U.S., Mexico, and Canada will have to take up and what have you. But the reality is, if the American president wants to put a tariff on products, he can do so. If that's his policy, that's his policy. And that's what the way it is, you know? He put tariffs on other products, and Biden and him did not remove the tariffs. And that's what happens too, you know. You put these tariffs on, and people don't move them because they get revenue from them, and they ain't trying to give up that revenue. So, we have another caller on the line. Go ahead, caller, we're listening to you. All right, no other caller? Okay. All right, we have some texts here. It says, Grover Cleveland won the popular vote in three presidential elections, 1884, 1888, and 1892, and is the only U.S. president to serve non-consecutive presidential terms from 1885 to 1888, 89, and from 1893 to 1897. Trump is not the only president who has attempted to break this non-consecutive trend, but history is not on the side of Donald Trump. I'm a libertarian. That doesn't measure on the spectrum of absolute libertarianism. I want to see a woman, especially a black woman, my sorority sister. She is an AKA, I am an A58, elevated to the highest position in the free world, but lean more towards Trump on a majority of issues, not personality. Jumping the results, laugh out loud. I come silent for the explanations if Trump loses. Well, I will tell you this much. I'd love to know. what the non-personality issues are that make you lean Trump. I really would. I swear I would love for somebody to give me an articulate reason for that, because I just cannot see. I don't know what it is, but again, you may clearly know, and it is your choice. This text says, pray for your recovery. I voted a week and a half ago. Okay, there you go. Yeah, I see, first of all, most Bahamians, as far as I can see, have never actually seen or read the platforms of the political parties that operate in the United States of America. Okay, arising out of these parties' convention are policy documents describing their policies on various issues. And most Bahamians ain't never seen them policy positions. Now, policy positions, like our manifestos and plans, might only be that, a published document for campaign purposes, because when you get in power, you do all kind of things that people say, well, you ain't mentioned that. And then you do other things that in the platform you say, yeah, I mentioned that, but that ain't my priority right now. Right? So I'm sorry, but I give you 10 hours to give me a cogent layout of Donald Trump's policies. A cogent argument. I can tell you this much. If you do it today, you'd have to go study, because you ain't have a debate. Donald Trump is a personality politician. Lots of people love what his persona represents. What his policies represent? I'd love somebody to tell. What's his education policy? What's his health policy? What's his fiscal policy? What's his monetary policy? You know what I find interesting? Very often, when Donald Trump says things, you have some staffer who has to come and behind him and clarify it. Really? Clarify it? Massage it? Clean it up? And you're the leader? No, man. You said what you said and you meant what you said. Why didn't you say it clearly when you said it Kamala Harris, when I listen to her, honestly, when I compare her to some of what I regard as the stronger political candidates in the United States of America, men and women, I wouldn't put her in the upper tier among them. But does she present well? Absolutely. Does she have a good set of policies that I think would be useful and helpful? Yes. Does she seem to have the demeanor? Does the other guy? Please. Please. We've seen the other guy. We've been there, done that. Some of the folks who talk about Democrats and Republicans and their leadership and what it means for the Bahamas and economy and stuff, seem to miss all kinds of records that reflect things that they don't know what they're talking about. All kinds of things. America's economy today is the envy of the world. The envy of the world. I mean, every American is doing well. No, sir. There are some districts in America where people are in their unemployment level, and that, exceptional. Their economic growth, envy of the world. Under Joe Biden, same person who they say senile, of dementia, and all that kind of stuff. Same guy, same person. We have a call on the line. Go ahead, caller, we're listening to you.
Hey, Mr. Laing, how you doing?
I'm right here, man. How are you?
Great. I'm looking for a spanking. I'm looking for Kamala to spank him up tonight. spanking bad. But a serious piece of spanking on it, because he really don't, he really, he, Donald Trump really isn't running to really run because he want to make America great again. Donald Trump really running to stay out of jail because of all of the legal problems that he's in.
Mm.
That's basically what that's all about. All the legal problems. So that's why he's running. Mm. Because, I mean, he really don't have any serious policies that he's really he really want to put in place. If you listen to Kamala Harris' campaign, he has the real policies. All right? All Donald Trump is doing is insulting people and insulting nations. That's basically it. And that's what I heard.
You know, one of the things I find interesting is that Donald Trump said he wants to make America great again. And for the people who support Donald Trump, I'm going to give you all the last 15 minutes to please answer this question for me, please. You can call the show, 323-6232-325-4316, or you can text me. And I'd like you to answer this question for me. The word again can only be applied where something existed before. Okay? So I want to become... I want to become president again means you had been president before. I want to be the government again means you had to have been the government before. So make America great again means it's not great anymore and it was great before. Please text me and tell me what period of time it was when America was great. Please. Give me the year or years when America was great so that you can make it great like that. Or better again, please. Any one of you. So this texter says, Sissy Allen says, the policies that Donald Trump has are policy of anti-war industrial complex, his tax policies, his pro-life and abortion restrictions, stronger border immigration, his position on environmental deregulation, taxes, lower corporate tax rates, and adjust individual tax brackets. Okay, so with the greatest respect to you, Brother Allen, now I want you to put those words in Donald Trump's mouth, either in video or written, and send them to me, please. I don't want any constructive words by you. I want you to send me where I can go and get I'd love to get it. You don't have to send it today. You could take your time. You could put your collage. That's what you're gonna have to do if you can find it. Put your collage together of those things and tell me and show me where they are. But I swallow U.S. election like you. This text says, "Great show as usual. Let's address the elephant in the room. Will he get?" Lock up if he lose the election. And I wouldn't know. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take our final break. You're listening to Z-Live on Zhivargo Laing, your host. We'll be back after this break.
Cleveland Clinic is recognized as a leader in healthcare. Our team of experts relentlessly pursues the best for our patients. From groundbreaking cancer research to state-of-the-art heart surgery, life-saving innovations happen here every day. When it's time to travel for your health, it's time to travel to Cleveland Clinic, your destination for care. for every care in the world. To learn more, visit clevelandclinic.org/Caribbean.
Do you have uncontrollable debt? Are you ready to make that move to Fidelity for a stress-free future? These loans have a built-in savings plan that pays you unbeatable interest. Ask about our debt consolidation loans today. Call 356-7764.
Fidelity, we're good for you.
This October, Dunkin' Donuts is brewing more than just coffee. We're brewing strength because we're stronger together. Donate at any Dunkin' location to support breast cancer awareness, and we'll match every dollar you give. Together, we're making a real difference for the Sister Breast Cancer Support Group. SIF Smile Support. When we stand together, we're stronger together because the Bahamas runs on Dunkin'.
Is Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, quality.
I'm not afraid, I'm not afraid to take a stand, take a stand. Everybody, everybody, come take my hand, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm, whatever weather.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. So glad you could join us for these remaining moments of the show. I trust that you are well. If you want to call us in these last moments, you can call us on 323-6232 or 325-4316. You can text me on 4224796 or WhatsApp me on 4393043. It's election day in America. They are at the polls.
I'm not afraid, I'm not afraid to take a stand, take a stand.
Put my life back together.
Simeon Hall. I grew up through a dead-end corner called Choke Neck Alley off Market Street. I dropped out of school in the fifth grade and worked as a carpenter's helper for Michael Pine Company. But it was while in the alley I discovered my life's calling was to preach the gospel. A Catholic nun at Aquinas night classes inspired me when she told the class that we all were made in God's image. It's a long way from Choke Neck Alley to preaching throughout the Bahamas, the Caribbean, and all the inhabited continents of the world. The circumstances of your birth need not dictate what you can do or where you can go in this life. Young man, drop your gun. Find your life's highest purpose. Lift yourself from the gutters of crime. Your next crime might lead to your death, and loved ones will have to bury you. Eternity is just ahead. In which section will you spend it? Non-smoking or smoking? Heaven or hell? You are made in God's image. So this week, attend a church of your choice and reconnect with God.
Loss of family members is very isolating, and people who have experienced loss appreciate when others have shared their grief. If you can't be there in person, go to the Nassau Guardian's website online at thenassauguardian.com and visit our obituary link. The Nassau Guardian's interactive obituary link allows you to read the funeral announcement, express condolences, or place photos on the online guestbook for one full year. Losing a loved one is painful, but that pain isn't the worst thing to happen. Friends, loved ones, colleagues, and neighbors who ignore the loss compound the pain. Should the bereaved family wish to place the obituary and photos on our obituary site, just contact the Guardian's Funeral Industry Partners or the Nassau Guardian. Remember, there isn't one magic right thing to say to someone experiencing loss that will make the loss less painful or easier to bear. The Nassau Guardian's obituary link, available online at thenassauguardian.com.
Welcome back. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Sea Live for these remaining moments of the show. We have been talking about U.S. Presidential elections and what might or might not happen, some perspectives on how things are going. I think it is. I'm never surprised that the U.S. has tight elections because the U.S. tends to, rather by popular vote, tends to have tighter elections. Their electoral college victories for most candidates tend to be respectable, meaning that there's not a 2 or 3 point difference. You can have blowouts. Reagan may have had a significant blow. I think he won practically every state. So you can have that happen and so forth. What is likely to happen this time? I think somebody's going to win by 300 plus college votes this time around. I think Kamala Harris is going to win the popular vote by millions. I think that that is true. I believe that there are going to be some surprise results reflected in the exit surveys of these elections coming up. And I think that we are going to have more of the same. If Donald Trump loses, you're going to have more. They cheat. They stole it from us. I never lost. I never will lose. I never can lose because I could never lose because I'm Donald Trump. And the only way I could ever lose is if you cheat me. If I cheat you, that's just known how to play the game, and that's how smart and brilliant I am, because I'm a stable genius, and so forth and so forth. That'll be just par for the course. And whoever, and if Kamala wins, she just has to go on and be president and do what she has to do, just like Joe Biden went on and did the presidency as he did. I tell you this much. I think that Republicans many, many Republicans, even those who speak for Donald Trump or who may not speak for him but don't say anything against him, I think they have a secret desire for this election to undo Donald Trump so that they can finally be rid of that sore in their electoral process. I believe that that is a deep-seated desire that many have. And we'll see. We'll see how it works out. You've been listening to Z-Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. God spares life. We'll be with you again tomorrow. Y'all have a fantastic evening.
Everybody, everybody, come take my hand, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm, whatever weather, cold or warm. Let me know that you're not alone. All of you feel like you can't complain. They know it's
this is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.